Welcome back, everyone. Today we're having a look at a dinosaur reanimator list. Yeah, that's something. It's maybe not the most competitive reanimator list, but it's kind of archetype that I wanted to show off because, well, let's have a look at it. The reason I wanted to build something like this was because of this card, Gishath, Sans Avatar. Whenever Gishath, Sans Avatar deals combat damage to a player, reveal that many cards from the top of your library, put any number of dinosaur creatures from among them onto the battlefield, and the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. So, I wanted to rig it so that if you play Gishath and if you get the ability off, you kind of win the game. And that's almost true here. I didn't really get there, but... We have a lot of big threats that you can hit with this. You can hit the Setalpa Primal Dawn, which is flying, double strike, vigilance, trample, indestructible. Pretty huge, big creature, hard to deal with. And we have Nessahal, which is also the only creature we can actually cast in this deck. And it can be countered. You have no maximum hand size. Whenever an opponent casts a non-creature spell, draw a card. And you can discard three cards to remove it and put it back again. So it's essentially always indestructible as long as you have cards in hand. So these are three really big threats. And it doesn't really matter which one you reanimate. But of course Gishath is the best one. Everything else in this deck is just centered around reanimating it. We have Connive Concoct. Concoct can return a creature card from the graveyard to the battlefield. And we have Rise from the Grave to do the same. We wanted to do it... as fast as possible. That's why we have these cards. We don't want to wait really for Eldest Reborn because we're slow as it is. So we just want that creature immediately get Gishath up and just attack immediately and try to get something done because we've just dirtled around until turn 5 essentially. We have Ritual of Soot to do something in the early turns, and hopefully with all this card draw we'll be able to draw into it, because actually, the deck is kind of tight to fit anything into. We need all the reanimator spells, and we need all these spells to reanimate, and we need all the discard outlets, and there's honestly not that much room. So all that I could fit in, except for that, are Ritual of Soot. But we have an interesting sideboard, which we're going to talk about in just a second. Here we have Rix Mardi Reveler, which is just essentially a discard outlet, but it's also a fine card in itself. If you get the Spectacle off for some reason, you're probably winning already then. But if you do, you got some tricks to do there. That's Short, of course, which I think is one of the best discard outlets currently in Standard. And Radical Idea and Tormenting Voice to discard cards. They're not super exciting, but they're there to fill a role. Basically, you want to get rid of all the Nessahal, Setalpas, and Gishaths that you get into your starting hand. Just put them in the graveyard as quick as possible with all this discard. And that's essentially the deck, but let's have a look at this sideboard, because if we're up against something like Control, we're not going to have a use for Ritual of Soot. So the only thing we do then is we bring in Eldest Reborn instead of Ritual of Soot, and all our cards are kind of active against them. So we just try to force through a creature for as long as possible. Just try to revive. That's probably one of our best matchups, I think, because against Control, you can probably dirtle around for four turns, and they're not going to kill you. So, and if you... manage to get a Rise from the Grave, Connive Concoct, or an Eldest Reborn off against them, then you're probably even likely to win against them, I think. So that's not the worst matchup. The worst matchup for this deck is going to be Mono Red. It's hard to do much in this deck to combat Mono Red. I think I've done a decent job at least to do something against them. What we do against Mono Red is we bring out all the Nessahal, Setalpas, and Gishath. All of them come out, and then we bring in Lyra Dawnbringer, Palakka Worms, and Verdant Sun's Avatar. You're probably familiar with Palakka Worm. It gains you 7 life, and when it dies, you draw a card. Lyra Dawnbringer has lifelink, a 5/5. And Verdant Sun's Avatar. Whenever the avatar or another creature enters the battlefield under your control, you gain life equal to that creature's toughness. So it gains you 5 life. And then the next creature which comes into play gains you life. So we just switch into a life-gaining machine against Monorad. It's not certain that this is going to be enough against them. You might very likely be dead by turn 5. Even if you get the Ritual of Soot off. So... Well, it's difficult, but at least we have some kind of game against them after sideboard. And that's pretty much the deck. For the land base, well, since we need a lot of different colors here, I went with all the... Maybe I didn't need all the shock lands and check lands, but I included all of them. You probably don't need too many lands. I've included 24 here. You could maybe go down lower if you think about the amount of draw and discard we have here. We're probably gonna draw into enough lands, I think, at least. But with my luck, you know, who knows? Who knows, right? So yeah, that's the list. I'm hoping to try it out at some point. I'm not expecting this to be super competitive, as I said. I think this will be... maybe get, you know, catch some people off guard. But that's about it. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.